Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending upon the time you are seeing this video. On behalf of Knowledge Infinity, today I am going to present a short video on what is the difference between simple interest and compound interest. Like my last video where I reflected on the topic reflection and refraction of light, the difference between them, today also I am going to give a short descriptive video on what is the difference between simple interest and compound interest. Now up to class 7th student, you are familiar with the simple interest formula. That is, simple interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. Suppose you are going to class 8th now, you are not knowing about compound interest. So this video you take it as an introduction to compound interest. Now what is simple interest? You know PRT upon 100, but in real life, anywhere this simple interest formula is not applicable. In banking, when you go and deposit a sum of money, simple interest formula is not applicable. For depreciation of machineries in accountancy and all, this simple interest formula is not applicable. So in reality, in real life, compound interest formula is only applicable. Now what is the difference between simple interest and compound interest? Let me explain you with the help of an example. Let us take an amount of or a principal of 100 rupees which you are depositing in a bank at a rate of 10% for a time of 2 years. Now when you calculate simple interest for the whole tenure, so simple interest will be very easy. PRT upon 100 means 100 into 10 into 2 upon 100, which comes up to your rupee 20. So rupee 20 will be simple interest for this amount for 2 years. Now when you calculate the compound interest for the same value, 100 rupee, 10% and 2 years, what is the difference? Yeah, what it is done, that compound interest is calculated every time for a tenure of 1 year, and at the end of each year the amount which is garnered, it is added to your principal. Now for the same example, if I am calculating simple interest for a time of 1 year, means 100 into 10 into 1 upon 100, it comes as rupee 10. At the end of first year, 10 rupee interest you have got. Now this 10 rupee interest will be added to your 100 rupee, and then interest will be calculated for the second year in case of compound interest. Means interest for second year will be 10 plus 100, that is 110 into 10 into 1 upon 100, which comes your rupee 11. So total interest will be your rupee 10 plus rupee 11, that means rupee 21. Now you see, for the same principal of 100 rupee at 10% and 2 years, simple interest came to be 20 rupee, compound interest is coming to be 21 rupee. So for any time interval, if it is more than 1 year, compound interest will be always greater than simple interest. For a time of 1 year, simple interest and compound interest is same. Now lastly, I will end the video with the formula for compound interest. Formula for compound interest means there is not a direct formula for compound interest. First you have to calculate the amount, and then you will subtract the principal. So amount in case of compound interest will be principal into 1 plus r upon 100 raised to the power n. P will be principal, r will be rate, and n will be time. This is the formula. So this was basically the difference between simple interest and compound interest. Thank you.